Hallelujah. Glory to God. Okay, so this video now is the task, the work I'm giving to everyone who love Nigeria. Anyone who wish Nigeria good. Anyone who want to see killing in Nigeria. Who want to see corruption in Nigeria. Who want to see fraud. All the calamity that we are seeing in Nigeria. Anybody who want to see ritual that we are seeing in Nigeria to end. Anyone who want to see the wickedness and the evil in Nigeria. If you are one of them that don't want to see it continue, join in this prayer. This is the prayer. Whether you are AAC or you are PDP or you are APC, you can join in this prayer. This prayer. You can join. But I have to tell you the truth. Even if like BP, APC or PDP, I'm not a politician. And I will never be. But God anointed his children to guard and to guide the affairs of men. To guide and lead them in the way of righteousness. Because righteousness exalt a nation, but sin is a reproach to anybody. You can see the reproach that country called Nigeria. You can see the reproach, the shame and disgrace that's upon that country because of sin. Because of sin. Thick sin. Deep sin we are seeing. The pastor, the church goers, the politicians is swimming in, and they don't want to see somebody who will bring light to that nation or bring the real change in that nation. But they are liars. If the Christians can wake up, if the youths can wake up, whether you are Igbo or whether you are Hausa, whether you are Yoruba, it is not what matters. What matters is if that land is good for all of us. If that land is destroyed, and is for all of us. It's time for us to take every tribalism, take away every division, take away every angry spirit, take away every backbiting and every hatred and the evil. Just take it away. It is better for us to first of all see good restored in that land. It is very, very important for us. As a child of God, if you love good, you need to pray for that country. Now, as this election is coming, we all need to join hands together in prayer. But never forget what I am saying. I still said AAC is the answer to Nigeria problem. I repeat it again. Is the answer to Nigeria problem. AAC is the man. Mr. Sowore is the man. He is the man. Because I stand with a man that is standing in truth and in righteousness. I stand with a woman that stands in truth and in righteousness. So, no other party, APC, PDP, have destroyed so many youths, so many future, so many great destinies. They have destroyed so many things in Nigeria. And they keep on coming every time, promising you heaven and earth, only for them to get there, only for them to get into that place. You can see the high level of corruption and the wickedness and the evil that is in the life of the people that's ruling you all these years, promising you change, only for them to come to set you ablaze, to set you ablaze daytime. So I think this coming in election need you to rethink, need you to say, let my common sense come back to me. What is really wrong? What is happening? Tell that cause to leave you. Nigerians, Nigerian youths, both youths, small, aged, old, everybody supposed to say, let common sense come back to me. We need real change. We need real change. And that change can only come to this young man called Mr. Sowore. So I don't want to take much of your time. I want to give you the prayer to pray. The prayer that we all of us should pray from now. Everywhere, anywhere you are, please, I advise you to do this prayer. Very important. Very important. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 from verse 3. Prayer point. Pray, especially all the supporters of AAC. Listen, this prayer is very, very important. Very, very important. You know, if you love Nigeria, if you want to see all this killing and all this evil and all this devil and demons to be no more, do this prayer. Please join in this prayer. It's very, very important. This prayer is powerful enough. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 from verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. Though we are living in the flesh, we are not fighting according to the flesh. We are not warring in the flesh. Just listen. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for bringing down strongholds. Open your mouth anywhere you are. Begin to pray and pull down strongholds that hold Nigeria bound. There is a stronghold that holds Nigeria bound. I said that good will not happen. Anywhere you are, this is for you. Open your mouth and begin to set that stronghold on fire. If you don't know what to pray, say, that stronghold, I set you on fire in the name of Jesus. If you're a Muslim, say, that stronghold, you know, I will be destroyed. Just, you know, begin to pray. Everybody, this one is for everybody. Say, that stronghold, I say that good will not happen in Nigeria. I set it on fire. I consume you. Put it down. Set it on fire. Consume it. Let it be consumed by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Let the fire in the blood of Jesus open your mouth and decree for that stronghold to be crushed. Do it. This time I'm saying, do it. Do it. Pull down the strongholds in Nigeria that hold Nigeria bound. Good. As we do that, because when you are doing it, it's God-empowered weapon that you are releasing. The weapon that eyes cannot see, but as I'm speaking it, is more powerful and more deadly than any American marine power or any weapons in the whole world. It can go into that place and set it on fire where you don't know. It can enter into a rock, it can enter into the water, it can enter into the bush and set them ablaze. So let us pray and pull down, crush that stronghold that say that Nigeria will not be free, that Nigeria, that light will not come in that great nation called Nigeria. Pull it down. Okay, we move on. Okay, for the weapons of our, as I said to you, for bringing down strongholds. Verse 5, casting down argument and every heightened that exalt itself against the knowledge of God. What is argument? Casting down argument. Would he win? How can he win? When Atiku is there? When Buhari APC is there? Who is he? Who knows him? Who is that small boy called Sowore? Isn't that, you know, how can he even win? This is what is called warfare, argument, warfare, no, argument in the inside. warfare in the mind that is going on. Arrest it. Arrest every warfare in the mind of the people. Saying, how can you win? Somebody wrote me a comment and saying that he did not see him winning. APC, PDP do this, APC do this, this and do that. This is not the way our God is. Our God, there is no impossibility with our God. With our God, all things are possible. Take that limitation off you. Take that limitation off you. The highest power is what I'm giving you. Take that limitation off you totally. To take it off. Take it off. Okay? Remove it. The God that gave his word, and his word pregnates Mary, and Mary gave birth to a son, the savior of the whole world. The one that told Moses to put his rod in the Red Sea, and the Red Sea was parted into two, and they crossed, his own children crossed in a dry land, and the enemy come in. The same water swallow up all the enemy. The same one that sent that told Moses in the land of Egypt, and he sent his and all the firstborn Egypt wiped out. So you can understand. The man, the one who told Abraham, I will bless you and become a blessing. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. So take off every, when it comes to our God, take off every limitation of you, every limitation of him, of your life. There is no limitation when it comes to our God. Good. So, arrest that argument, that warfare in the mind. Say, every argument, casting down arguments, every argument in the heart of people that they are throwing and weighing and saying something negative against him, war, and say, every argument and every high thing that exalts itself above the counsel of God, I cast it down. I cast it down. Casting down argument and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Arrest that warfare in the inside. That argument, cast it down. Abort that evil pregnancy. Cast it down. Arrest that argument. Argument. Who is Sowore? How can he win? Where did he come from? Who is his father? Who did he know? Arrest it. Arrest it. Arrest it. Child of God, arrest it. Open your mouth. I say every warfare in the mind. The warfare is in the mind. Arrest it. Hold it captive. Casting down every argument and every heighten that exalts itself above what God is saying now in Nigeria. I say number one, set strongholds. Every stronghold in Nigeria, embrace. Number two, cast down every argument and every heighten that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. Then number three, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Now every thought must obey. Every thought in Nigeria, all over the world, arrest every thought, every evil thought, every disobedient thought that is saying no to what God said, that is saying no, arrest it. They must obey. Arrest it, hold it captive, and command everything to obey the word of God. Let what God said stand. Let the word of God stand. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God stands forever. So, forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. Now, these three prayer points I gave to you in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10, from verse 3 to 5, is important. Set every stronghold in Nigeria on fire. Cast down every argument, every warfare in the mind of the people over the counsel of God. Cast it down. Arrest every disobedient thought. Hold it captive. Every thought must obey now what God intended to do, what God said about Nigeria. God bless you. I'm so glad. I'm so happy as you share this video, as you cause many believers to know the right thing to do, as you open their eyes to know the right prayer to pray. Now, for us to achieve this great goal that God has set before us, I said, God bless you as you spread it, as you contact people, as you let them join in this prayer. If possible, I think we all need to choose a date. Everybody have to pray. Everybody have to pray before, but it doesn't matter. Anywhere you are, just pick up this prayer point and begin to pray. I am praying it every day. You are doing it every day. From now, every day, every night, morning, afternoon, night, this is your task. This is what you can do. As you are praying it and doing it, make sure you also tell people about what God wants to do and let them know about AAC. You know, make advice is needed. People's awareness, create awareness. Stop folding your hands. You know, it's something, you know, by force. You know, you must take it by force. Stop keeping quiet and folding your hands and saying, okay, God, do it. Christians these days are sleeping. They are all sleeping. And the children of the darkness, the people of the darkness, they are waxing strong because they don't sleep in the night. They are busy doing what their master, the devil, tells them to do. But it is time for us to awake. Awake, oh, you are sleeping, and the light will shine on you. Awake, oh, sleepers, all you that is sleeping. Sleep, wake up from your slumber. It's time for you to wake up. Christians supposed to be, we are a warrior, like an army. We are the armies of God here on earth. Our army is always alive. Army is always ready to fight, ready to defend, ready to do what they know that is the right thing or what is needed of them. So it's time for us to do what? To know that we are the army of God and clear up the enemy through this prayer. Take over everything. Take over the good that God has given to us. Take over the nation back from the evil and from the wicked and from the vampires, from those that is feeding the devil with the blood of the innocent people in that nation. As I said to you, nothing good comes from PDP, nothing good comes from the APC. The answer is AAC. I said it again, and I keep saying it because I want good. Did you that is hearing me, did you want good? Did you love good? Are you standing in good? Who are you? Which one are you standing for? Which one are you standing for? Are you standing in truth? Are you standing in righteousness? Did you wish good to your neighbor? Do you wish good to that nation? Did you truly wish good? Okay. See you. Bye-bye. And please, no more sleeping. Pray with that season. And God is good. Bye for now. Remain blessed. And as you are praying, God bless you. As you are praying for yourself. Remember, anything that you are doing for other people, you are doing for yourself. Anything you are doing for yourself. Okay? So, anything you are doing for people, you are doing for yourself. As you do this prayer, as you are praying for Nigeria to be good, you are doing yourself a favor. And the good will fill your life. Good will not depart from you.